You could say that.
You say it anyway.
Sit down.
Right, one more.
back or forget one or other of the harms of the movement. Let's have a little bit of shocking music.
Let's try out the music.
It's AABBBAAABBBAABBBA.
Something I like.
It changes from A to B as they change the figure. That's right. The ones to start to kick, oh yes. You're right. Let's have a bit of that. Right, that's enough rest for me. Do the break at the end. Do the break. do the hang again. It's part of the ride, that's right, you don't have to do it again. And progress now to three. All right. That's right. This is the top, front end.
Thank you. Right.
So foot up, two whole hays, and a foot up again. Right. Then we go into the cast. Go into back to back with your cast. Face across. Back to back. You cast left shoulders, as I said. Right. Okay. Watch the lines, of course. If you think of it as two across, two to move sideways, and two to come back, you are far wrong. We should add to the music, right?
Thank you.
And in principle, foot Danube does. The problem's getting from one to the other, right? Having done the kick up, right? Then you turn into the meow, right? Turning eight, of course. Different, yeah. I forgot which side I was. That's right. Let's just practice that.
Second.
It's gentle to say, try and get your toes together. Now try and make a... That's right. I suppose the arm is always for the hunting for new traditions. So everyone's different, you know, there's always kinds of things which are unlike anything else again. Right, it starts with the cast figures we've done already, and we do it twice through. Right? We then dance spots in your partner, so you face in, and you dance three on the spot, and you jump into line, like half jib. Left shoulder first time, of course, just to add confusion, and back to place. And the second time, right shoulder. Being a good tradition, you see every dance is slightly different. It's more or less the same, each figure. And each dance, but, you know, each one is slightly different. I can remember the chord. That's why I haven't used the list. I just can't remember what all the subtleties are. So don't get stressed. Then it's corners cross, as we did at Maid of the Mill, you know, to change places, then corners come back, right? And reins, of course, to end. That's a more or less standard sort of thing. Feel happy enough to go straight through it? Yes. one dance that was done with a lady. So can I get one set to disintegrate and get three sets facing across? I can see eight people there, and I can see eight people here.
Coming back. Two more in.
One more. Two more. It's the same number of people, there are more people sitting there. Right. Foot up, foot up, foot down, foot down. Right, doubling up the feet. Foot up, foot up, foot down, foot down. Right. Then corners, which is back to back across the corner, is danced in fours with eight of us, right? So you're working units of four. The second corner does a back to back. Just walk it. Left shoulder, that's right, and back there. And then the first corner is the dance back to back. And naturally we do it twice in the dance. So foot up, foot down, corners and fours, second, first, and we do that through twice. Then we dance spots. Now we're getting good at spots, aren't we? You end up right shoulder, this is a right shoulder spot each time. Like you're jumping right shoulders. Both times. Don't worry if you get it wrong, it's only a passing impact. Then back to back with your partner, and of course back to back is the left shoulder, it's the other one. That's right, yeah. And we, of course, we'll do that twice. That doesn't matter. So far, so good. You'll all recognise those words when we get to them, right? Now, the rings. We walk rounds, right? 12 steps, 1, 2, 3, 4, nice springy steps. And then you do a break facing the way you're going, kicking the one in front of you at the back side. Yes, didn't I? And then you turn in and come back. What a weary looking crew. All you need is chains and balls.
Or is that the implication?
It's all right, you know, you get out of this prison after lunch. It's not a life sentence. Right, and then finally you face into the middle, and it isn't a dance on the spot. You dance into the middle and out and in and lift. Right, two in, two out. Can I just do that one? Right, okay. Wow, do you really want to? No, you. It says you lift mascot.
Mascot.
Would you like to put your beer back here? No, what they normally do this from memory is bring the fool, bring somebody in at the end. You don't dance around somebody all the time, it's not practical. Right. So we're going to do this last bit, okay?
I'll start.
Thank you.
your foot.
That's all right. Any time.
At one time, I used to distinguish in my mind two types of Cotswold conditions. The ones that were trains, like Sherborne, Fieldtain, Bafton, and the ones that were came to the yard, like having the mention sign. You switch on the record player and it goes on to the end of the record. And it certainly is, there's no sort of, when we talk about phrasing and showing that, but it doesn't really apply in this. It has a different sort of feel about it.
Where's your legs?
I'm enjoying it. I really am. Well, that's 5 out of the 9 we've done so far. I'm not doing too badly. The next one, the short one, what is jockey? Jockey to the fair. Known as jockey off because it's the leaving dance. And normally done by everybody in one big set. Yeah, let's do it. No, I'm not sure we can actually. No, this field is not big enough.
Alright, it sets of six then. And you start off standing in a line across the top of it.
As we finished off figure eight. That's a six, and that's a six.
Nine
six. This is a
number three. We're missing one. This one's missing four.
Let's just walk away from it. You
dance in the line.
You dance in the line. Yeah, it's not the countdown. Nor the five bears, yeah. We dance in the line and break. And then you cast back into a set.
Now, cast.
Surely we can get six out of it.
There
are about 3,000 ways of choosing six. Still only five, that's about it. To cast back, you in effect, the two halves of the front line turn out, right? And the line casts, as it were, around, so that you're a long way set as normal, with the people in the middle at the top. Yeah. And what's more, you have all 8 bars to do that in. Foot down we can do, yes. Down is still the same direction. Then foot up. And then we cast back again to make a line of six at the bottom. And you cast from this end. So you turn, as it were, and dance so you're a line of six at the bottom. No, you're actually still in the middle, that's right. You're right. Generally say, I don't think I go anywhere, it's probably quite right. Then you all turn to your right to face me. You dance up to where you started. Turn to your right. And follow your leader, who's now the one at the other end, yeah. Who dances off in a serpentine path wherever they want to, through the other set. Into the river. Right, let's work on this. We'll probably have to come up. Turn to face me. You're not in the order you started, right?
Yes.
You shouldn't be. Now, we've got to say, they don't have to do it now with everybody, the whole team, or everybody who's there. You know, when they've got visiting sides, they all make this enormous line, and it completely fills the car park. It's typical of Morris' stupid behaviour, as you can imagine. Right, can we have jockeys to the fair? With 8 bar music. Yeah.
ABC.
£8,000
between these dance and the tune, that, you know, it's terribly important. Right, so it starts with a foot up and foot down. Now that you can do. I've noticed that, right? It starts then with a back to back left shoulders, back to back right shoulders. You can do that as well. Well, I know the left shoulder one you can do. Then we get to the difficult bit. Right, there's a funny pattern that we've got to achieve. It's the set. You start like this. I get why we're working this lot, do you? You're getting too far away. All right then. Number 2 and 5 approach to me, and the other 4 line up on them, so 2 lines and 3 facing across on the dome, right? You take 2 back to where you were. You take 2 bars to get to that position. Ready? 1 and 2. Right. We now have 2 heavy bars where you thump the ground good and hard. 1, 2, 3, and then you pass left shoulders, that's right. You pass the person to their place. And you end up in a column, not twisted, not like a happy about so fun? Just back to where you were, let's try and get everybody to do it. The people who approach first are number 2 and 5, the first corner, second corner I should say, the one who goes first. Oh my God. It's 2 and 5. They go to meet and the others line up on it. They do that. Hard on the ground and it passes through. Who are now you and you. Right? That's right, you've not actually got numbers on your backs, that's it. And you've never seen them before either. That's the other diagonal approach, and you line up across the other diagonal, right? And do the same thing. Clonk on the ground, pass their shoulders.
I'm just here.
Now, the third, that's half the figure. It's difficult to actually know how to describe this. It's what, if you weren't worrying about who you are, is the second corner, there's actually the last, the two people who actually haven't met in the middle yet. Right? They do it, and you line up. From the audience point of view, it's the same as the first time, right? Except you've all moved around a bit. Right? You pass through, then you face your opposite, and we do it with our opposite. You go forward, thump on the ground, pass left shoulder, and you're back where you started. the column, as you did before. Cast back and face in. Now we go into the weirder figure. Oh, you were discussing photocopy?
Yeah.
Oh, somebody didn't want to know. I like the punishment you do. You dance in line. You dance in line like this, and then you
this
and cast back until you make a step. Well, you can't stay. Difficult to explain to start with, but it comes all right out once we've worked on it, right? The centres, right? They dance forward to meet face to face. Most of this dance, you're not going anywhere, you just go forward and back, so it's lovely to be in the middle, you don't have to think, right? The second corner, that's this diagonal, right? They dance past this pair in the middle, passing on the left shoulder, and stop as soon as you pass them. I'll show you what I mean.
Oh,
come back. Basically, we need to get back. Right? Now, my problem, you see, is that while you go forward, we're going to do, in effect, a back-to-back, and we wait halfway round. You see what I mean? Go forward. While those other two dance all the way round that way. And then we go back to everybody, this you and I, we carry on. And they go back to where they started.
And we just go.
Right, so one corner has changed places, one corner's gone all the way round back to where they started, and the other one hasn't done anything, right? Can we try that with music,
please?
Right, incredible. Let's just try that in effect, you've got one to get in because they're trying to get round you. You then hold the position for two bars a step, and then two bars back to where you are because you need the break. Yeah. Right? Now, you've only got six to get all the way round. It's all right, freaking. Right. So you do need to know it's only six bars. Let's try it again. Don't worry. Who worries, they say? Two bars hold. And then I'm not quite sure what to call the next bit, but you two go back to where you started, and you four change places. And break. Right, can I go back to where you were and let's do the music for that little bit? Start this figure, please. Otherwise, I'll be in this. Let's do the whole of that figure, though. The weirder bit and the almost crossover bit.
Almost
then do the last two repeats. You do the what those two do. We do this figure four times. First two, and then you two lead the last two. Right, so... Let's actually do the one they lead first, so you practice in the proper place.
Yes.
Right, once more. because there wasn't a whore in his hand to drive the fellows. It actually used to be known as the ferry. Even Ainsley are not prepared to go around the next and do a bunch of ferries.
Yeah.
position to be in. Twisting your ankle, you should learn about it. Right, now hands, you won't worry about the hands. We won't worry about the music either. Just realise he is a test. Classic Morris step for illness. Right. Hands. Swing down and up. Now, what has grown in this century is a fashion for very large Olympian swings. And yet, as collected, they are called short, small swingers, short swings. So, for the sake of this workshop, we will in fact have quite a small swing, don't we? Swing, I don't want to see the handkerchief right up here, I just want a gentle swing until you get to the jump. Now, one, two, three, hop, one, two, three, hop, one, hop, two, hop, snatch, and jump. Right, let's do it with music without the feet. To say your left and your right wouldn't help you.
Outside foot.
Outside, well, yeah, but it's not outside foot all the way through, you see. So left foot for the sound movement. That the distance people tolerate you getting close to them is sort of quite large, yeah? And touching and so on is very difficult. So that introducing ideas like let's dance by holding hands to get rhythm, yeah, communicate rhythm to each other, so on, doesn't even occur to people. And if you do get people to do it, they get very embarrassed. Shouldn't do, of course. By that, I mean, like, if you sort of dance, get the, come on, put your hands on your shoulders, that's right, stop being embarrassed. Ready? D, E, but E, D, E, D, D, E, 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 D, E,
D, E, D, E, D, E, D, E, D, E, D, E, D, E, D, E, D, E, D, E, D,
E, D, E, D, E, D, E, D, E, D, getting people to stay off the brain the same time, getting rid of it, can be worked up that sort of way fairly easily. Because you immediately tell who the odd one is at.
Who was it?
Me. Yes, mustn't forget those sort of tricks. I'll say, I had that problem with the snatch. Now, let's learn fingers. Foot up, right? Turn on the back step, top step, to face front, because we're going to dance these dances the way the notation described and the way they were done on the film that you haven't seen.
I'm sorry.
Yes. What's wrong with you? You've moved away from the camera there, come on. Right. Face up. And we dance. 1, 2, 3, hop. 1, 2, 3, hop. Turn 8 on the hops. 1, 2, jump, face front. That's your opposite. And we dance the second half facing across, right? 1, 2, 3. Now there's a reason for this. Ilmington, I haven't really got time to explain. Hayden had so many stops and starts. But we're really aiming at the sort of Ilmington that was done about 1890 sort of period, not the sand bedded. Sort was done later, and certainly not Sharp's reconstruction of what he thought was done in 1867, which is far from totally wrong. Yeah, got it wrong. Lots of story about that one. Right, that's foot up. Half jib. Pass each other, right shoulders to the other side. And then as you come back on the hops, turn to your left, all the way around. And jump to face front. Now there is, again, a good reason why it's like that. Come on, do the other side, that side, and turn to your right. Come back. Okay, don't turn too soon. I taught it like this the one at the beginning, but it didn't turn out that way. Cross and turn as you come back. Not over, and then turn and come back that way, right? It's important. It's important to rotate it later. Other way to what?
We're doing the second half.
Well, what happens if I do then?
We're doing the first half of the second half,
yeah. If you do it wrong, it's my privilege to complain. There was nothing in the rules that you complain about. Right, come on, let's play some music. Foot up, back to back. And as you come back, turn to your left. It's the same way as you did in half jib, except it's towards your opposite rather than away from. So the other half of it is past left shoulders and turn to your right. Yes. Can we get that to music? Between the middles right, who come up to the top, and then eight side bottoms. Come back to where you were, that's the first bit. I have to add a little bit more in there. Now remember, tops from the ends go between. Now, while they're passing, you turn out at the bottom. Right, so let's now do that. Through the middle and turn out at the bottom. Turn out at the top while they pass and go between your face. Between. Right? Between the middle, up the middle.
Uncertainty? No, all right. Beautiful.
there no description? Yeah, okay, fair enough, right. Is there no description of the hay in these names?
Description of the hay?
Yeah.
I date it.
Oh, right, yeah, fair enough.
Well, because it's a description of which is done in that period, and right. Things like hens, the ones in hens are normally described.
Okay, so...
Nothing like special about it.
Right.
This is, as explained on sheet, one of the dances where the former people of the peasant side are people who live in the village. The people who said they were associated with Morris and therefore can't be challenged. Right? Doesn't really matter, it's a good dance anyway. Right, the chorus, the start of the chorus, it's a progressive foot up. The first pair only dance foot up. They move up a baby yard during foot up, the only one foot up in the whole tradition where you move on. It all will turn as a dance on the spot foot up. Right? Let's have a bit of bumpers and strength.
Thank you.
nice slits to the rain. People were tripping over them.
Right.
and usually boring. But that's one of the number five constitutionally kind of colourful, so it's worth knowing that. You put the six, say, name of action. The keeper.
Thank you.
nice to do. It looks, from an audience point of view, simple movements are actually quite effective. And you know, the big problem with inventing dancers, of course, is to have an unusual idea which is still simple and effective. Now, I want to do a sidestep and half-pay dance, and I also want to introduce the idea of galleys in the tradition. Because before 1867, the tradition had galleys in it. It's fairly obvious because of the loops and turns that, you know, where galleys could occur, but those teams that I'm aware of which have worked on tradition and incorporated galleys say that they don't really fit in all the figures. So, we'll put them in the half jib and the cross and turn, but not in foot up and back to back. Right? So, foot up as we've just been doing. Half jib, let's just play a little bit of music. Old Mother Oxford, down on the other. Let's just try that, right?
Sidestep
and half-pay.
Yes,
we
Sorry?
I forgot the galley, didn't you? Off inside set.
No, I think I was in late for getting into the haze. When I'm doing the galley, I've got time.
The rest is
the same.
The obvious work
is
and the cost until.
It's a bit important to jump in. Shipton on Stour. And I think stinch is the way the manuscript has it. It's one of the problems with manuscript. People write down what they think they've heard rather than the way people might spell it on their birth certificate. It's part of the play. And that bean setting is very much the Headington bean setting tune. I know it doesn't say there, you know, but it's diddly da 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 Well, one's not sure whether it's a real Ilmington dance, but it's certainly a dance that Sam Bennett acquired from somewhere, and is referred to in Sharp's Morris books as, you know, the old man's dance, the three men in the circle, and the kick in the backside, that sort of thing. He's saying a version of that dance was seen in Warwickshire, or the South Midlands, or some phrase like that, and that's this dance. And it's an elementary act, just reels and the business part. It's rather as if the old man's dance from Lancashire actually had reels put into it. It's a very, very similar movement. And it fits into a sort of minor British tradition of comic dances, which the thing that we share with the Scandinavians and North Germans, things which are performed in a somewhat comic way, and they're very akin to horseplay when actually done. Anybody who's seen Shropshire Bedlam knows what I mean. Right, Buffoon just hangs us on. Bumpus we've done, Constant Billy we've done both versions of, Black Joe, Haste the Wedding, Harmony, Jubilee Dance, I think you can get all those. Keeper, Maiden Mill's the linked handkerchief dance, right? The problem was deciding always in the spin, you link across, what do you actually do? And the locals' advice was that the spin was not this, keeping a talk, was actually a big swoop. A big sweep. And when it's done that way, it looks much more effective. And of course, being a linked handkerchief dance, the villagers fall into the old trap of, isn't it nice, the last half hay for the two middles to go the other way, so that the handkerchiefs get knotted and you dance around with a star. That's great. Now, you'll find, at the back end on PhD, Old Molly Oxford. Now, that's structured differently to any other of the Ilmington dances. Now, the reason for that is in the history of the side itself. The quick history is 1804, George Arthur came to the village, set up a workshop, raised a Morris team. Haven't discovered where he's come from yet, so don't know whose Morris he was doing. What we do know, pipe and tabor, normal Cotswolds with galleys, all the way through. By 1867, I should say, the side had stopped. George Arthur's son was by then was actually the musician, Tom I think it was, playing for them, and his son-in-law, Joe Joseph, was actually the foreman. He apparently wasn't a very strong character, and he was the one who I said the other evening, they'd gone to Shipton on Stour, went on to Browse, had a fight, he ran all the way back, and people made life so unpleasant for him, he left. But by 1867, already dancers had got rid of the double step. They were single stepping throughout the dance. And Sharp, when he started inquiring, had some problems about trying to discover what it was, and he discovered that but his major informant, they said, oh yes, he often used to break into double step. So he went and asked him why, and he said, well, because that's the way it used to be done. Right? There was then, a bit later, a revival in the village under Michael Johnson, that's his name, yes, which definitely had single step and it lost the galley. And Sharp, in interviewing people, was attempting to recover what that was. And in his published letters in the newspapers where he was complaining about Morris, he was said about Ilmington that Sam Bennett's team is as uncouth as something or other, and They've lost all the fine features of the dance which I had recently reconstructed. That was his word, you know. Now, Sam Bennett's side didn't like that, and they went and inquired of the old people, you know, got to know them better, and said, well, what the hell's all this? And they said, well, even Sharp hasn't got it right either. Still, it ran on for a bit, stopped, died is rather the word, rather than stopped. And when the Bidford side got dancing in 1886, Ilmington themselves danced that year in Roy Judge's article for the Journal. There's no reference to a newspaper cutting show that Ilmington actually turned out at that time. 1887 was the Jubilee, and they brought Joseph Dobson back from Banbury, where he, you know, was hiding away, although he was in his 80s by then, and got him to lead the side. But as there were quite a few new dancers, the whole tradition was somewhat reconstructed. And unfortunately, it was three of this side that Sharp met to start with, and got a very confused idea of the dancers. After a year or two, that stopped. In 1897, Sam Bennett, who was a small boy, had actually learned the tunes of my paper, was involved in playing for them, and they got together a side where the dancers further changed. Not that the old dancers weren't far off. And in particular, they got a fascinating structure to the dance, whereas they had all the bits, but they got them muddled together, right? Stopped after years, got going in 1906. That was the one that Sharp criticised because they were invited up to London, you know, and told that wasn't the true Morris and so on. So Bennett got the dancers recollected, as it were, and then started teaching them again. And I think the last Ilmington side that was seen was sort of late 40s at the Stratford festivals. The EFGS says he brought children's sides across doing the definitive Ilmington. You know, so first thing to say, there's like eight revivals, eight variants of it around, and room for interpretation within all that. So you're likely to meet a number of ways of doing Ilmington. The only thing I can say is that the Sharp reconstruction is probably close, but not there. And there's some argument about which figures went and which dancers. And certainly in the Jubilee revivals, they were into the business of foot up a figure which you did ad lib and then rounds to finish. And the next dance had a different figure in the middle rather than going through the whole gamut of all the things. What is interesting about Old Molly Oxford, if you can think of it as I go through, read it out, you start with the foot up, as we've done, and face in. Then you go into another figure, which is always forward and back, not a half jib, just go to meet. And then half a figure, which could be half jib, back to back, cross and turn, or rounds. Then you do the side step to the left and right, and a half A to the other end. Then you do a side step to left and right, as if you were going to do the half A back. Instead of the half A back, you then do the other half of the figure you did half of. And then you face down and start with foot down and do it all again because the set's been reversed. And you carry on until you work your way through all the figures through this funny sequence. Now, it's worth, it is a thinking momentarily, as it were, about these revivals and why they're like. They kept all the elements together. It's that there being no outside influence to say this is the way the dance has got to be because of. They just put it together as they fancied it. You know, either as they badly remembered it or the chap preferred it in that sort of way. And there's an interesting sort of symmetry, a long-winded symmetry, I might say, in doing the dance this way, but it's quite interesting. Do you think we've got two or three minutes to try? Yes, go on. Play Old Mother Oxford, and we go straight into it, and you just do what you're told.
We always do.
No. We still have enough for two sets, I reckon. Oh, that's easy. It's only ABB all the way through it. In fact, I suspect that
once it's Spanish,
like our square, or the rings of the actually you can use it. Right? There should be two sets. Do you need one more on the bottom? set.
No, we need to.